yourself with how well you're playing right now?
A little bit. I mean, it's a, you know, it's a really tough injury. I'm not going to lie. I mean, it's a, you know, a lot of things go through your mind when something like that happens, right? So, but I just, you know, just went on my grind and just kind of chipped away at it day by day, and you know, I feel pretty good as a result.
Speaking of chip, is that what you and your teammates will have on your shoulders this year, the big chip?
Well, I mean, I think we have a lot of guys that have been kind of discarded, right, and been forgotten about. Myself with the injury and the age, and, you know, Jeremy and, you know, and a bunch of players who other teams really felt they had no use for. And so we, you know, we have that kind of attitude built into ourselves.
And before, you said a long time ago, you said you love a challenge. You love it when people doubt you. That way you can, that just motivates you. If that's the case, you got to be eating this up.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, right now though, honestly, it's you know, I'm kind of in a different place. It's really about maximizing our potential. And I think, you know, our philosophy is to get better every single day. I think when that happens, the results will come. I think proving people wrong will come. You know, but our focus must be on ourselves.
How's this different for you being in this situation as opposed to in the past and coming off a season where, you know, what happened to you? Are the juices flowing in a different way? Can you describe that?
Much more patient now being here, you know, because I won't have many of these left. So I just figure I might as well just bite the bullet and just act like I'm enjoying chewing it. So.
This morning you tweeted about the different emotions you feel coming into your 19th season. Can you tell us kind of what those emotions are?
Well, I mean, it's a, you know, it's a mixture of things. It's a mixture of excitement. It's a mixture of a little nervousness and you know, a little, you know, rage. You know, it's a mixure of a lot of things.
Where's that rage?
Are you angry this year because
well,
of
Well, just, you know, it's just, you know, just trying to see if I can prove to myself that, you know, I can be myself. And then, you know, all the words and the doubt just kind of adds fuel to that.
Well, talk about the challenge, though, what lies ahead for you personally, and not try to get more out of your body than you don't know what's there.
Well, I mean, the key is to always feel like you have something left in the tank at the end of the day. You know, in the past, I've always pushed myself to the limit, right? And then that's every day. And, you know, now I just got to be a little bit more patient and make sure that when you step off the court, you still have something left.
Kobe, how did you modify your game with the layoff? Did you add some new MOs to your game, new methods?
No, it's just it's always, you know, it's standard stuff. My game is kind of been my game since I figured it out in 2003 in terms of the basics of it. So. Really haven't had to change much from an offensive perspective.
Cole, can you elaborate on the using your leg now for the fadeaway J?
Yeah, you know, I mean, I started doing that really in 2005. I mean, I was having knee issues, so I really had to, couldn't elevate as much as I wanted to. So as a result, I've had to fade away a lot more, which was throwing my balance off quite a bit. So, you know, just looking for inspiration everywhere I could possibly find it and trying to perfect the shot.
As long as you know Byron, what was it like for you when you first heard that, yes, he's going to be our guy, and then where he can take you?
I was excited. You know, I mean, you know, Byron was my rookie mentor, so, you know, he took me under his wing the first year and really showed me the ropes of, you know, how to approach practice, how to prepare yourself, time management, you know, all the little things that I think were very important for a young kid to hear. So.
Onlookers, including your coach Byron Scott, seem to be pretty impressed by this five-on-five scrimmage that you had. Did you prove something to yourself during that scrimmage also?
Well, yeah. I mean, I hadn't played, right? So I'd spend the whole summer just kind of preparing and training. And you know, it was important for me to get a five-on-five game in so I could see what I can and can't do. And I felt like me.
So from your part, is there a nervous anticipation? You can hardly wait to get this thing going?
Not really about the game. I mean, just kind of doing this whole hoopla thing, right? And then you're just kind of, you know, kind of anxiously waiting for the first practice to get going and then preseason to get going. But also understanding that now, I mean, we're here now. We're going to blink. The season's going to be over. Right?
Cole,
so having that in perspective as well.
Cole, can you feel the Laker way being infused with Byron Scott, bringing back a lot of the same principles and disciplines?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's just it's a philosophical thing, right? I mean, he's... You know, he agrees with me and this Laker organization that, you know, we're here for one reason only, and that's to hang championship banners, right? Not division banners, not, you know, anything else. Western Conference, we don't do that, right? We focus on winning championships, and I think that's very important for our young guys to understand.
Describe the feeling deep inside, though, to be as much of an underdog as you guys are, and it's so different than ever before.
I haven't really paid attention to it too much. I mean, I know generally what the sentiment is, but I haven't paid attention to it. I don't think the guys should either. I think they should really just focus on, you know, our mission, which is just to get better every single day, and that's in paying attention to the details. And I think if we can do that, everything else will take care of itself.
What do you think about your, where your game is right now?
Well, I mean, yeah, I think the motivator, you know, at an individual level, it must start, right? So every individual must feel like they're maximizing their potential, and then maximizing their potential within the collective group. And I think that's going to be the philosophy.
Byron said he thought you could be a 23-24 point per game scorer. What do you think about that?
I don't know. I mean, it's just whether I am, I'm not. It doesn't really matter to me. It's where we go, you know, as a squad. I mean, offensively, I'm going to be fine no matter what. And I think defense and rebounding is where we really need to focus on. So, you know, I'm more really looking forward to seeing how I move my feet defensively. Staying in front of guys, chasing guys off the picks, things like that.
Do you need to do that in order for this team to be successful, be one of the leading scorers in the league?
No, I'm not. It's not. That shouldn't be our focus at all. Truly. I mean, you know, I think instinctively, you know, we'll all gravitate to what we do best on the basketball floor. But our primary focus is to be great defensively. And that involves taking that challenge every single night and trying to get better at it every single night. And personally, that's really the biggest challenge, because offensively, I can always dictate what I'm going to do. Defensively, it's reacting to crazy, right? No, that's a challenge that I really haven't had to deal with this summer yet. So I'm looking forward to seeing that.
Do emotions feel different at the start of camp this year compared to other times?
Honestly, a lot calmer. A lot calmer. I think it's 19 years coming in. You know, you know what to expect.
But even different from year 18? I mean, it feels different from a year ago? Even?
Yeah, because last year I didn't know what to expect. I didn't know when I was going to be able to come back and play. I mean, there's a lot of questions, right? And every day was kind of a process of trying to figure out what you can and can't do. When are you going to come back? What's the team going to, you know? Now there are questions, but they don't center around health. So.
Because of what's happened the last couple of years, do you find yourself really appreciating the ride even more now? Take that positive out of it?
Yeah, I mean, you always try to appreciate the journey, you know what I mean? And kind of try to take it all in, because you know you'll blink and it'll be gone. So.
It sounds like you're more about answering the questions in your mind rather than trying to prove anything to anybody else.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's, you know, I've always been that way, though. You know, I feel that to be a much healthier journey. And I think kind of on the way to doing that, you know, it's much more enjoyable to kind of look to the side every now and then and look at who you're proving wrong in the process. But that's not that's never been the main driver for me.
Is there anything you could tell the average fan out there and say, we're going to be better than you think because?
Not really. I mean, I think it's... You know, people are going to have expectations one way or the other. I mean, that doesn't really matter to me, honestly. I mean, we'll come here tomorrow. We'll start the process of getting to work. To get better every single day. And it sounds cliche-ish, but if you really think about it in its truest form, you know, that's the key. Because when you're getting better every single day, you can't help but to do phenomenal things.
Byron said that you were more focused this year than you've ever been in your career. Why is that?
I haven't played for quite a while, and I think it's the size of the challenge that's ahead of me, you know, has really forced me to really focus in a lot more than I ever have, and that's a 360 degree thing, right? I mean, that's nutrition, that's training, that's, you know, mentally preparing. I mean, that's everything. But to play at this age and through all the injuries, you have to have that commitment to it.
How do you see the conversation?
Part of Derek Jeter's journey wrapping up that you related to?
Well, yeah. I mean, the most touching moment for me was watching him walk off the field and walk through the tunnel and head back to the locker room. You know, that was the most touching part, because that was, you know, this is the last time that's going to happen. And then you try to put yourself in that position and imagine what that would feel like, right? And so, you know, even though epically, you know, hitting the game-winning single, you know, that seems to be the most touching thing. For me, it was the quiet moment of walking off the field that was most moving.
One of the toughest things when you're hurt is the mental part coming back and knowing what you can do with your body. Are you to that point now where you're not even thinking, you're just playing, or are there still issues there?
No, there's I'm just playing. I'm just playing. And that's even on the defensive end of the floor, just moving. Now it's just about kind of getting the timing down, getting the angles down. But I don't think anymore.
Cole, 19 years. How do you see conversations going between you and Byron Scott regarding managing minutes?
I don't really see it as much of a big deal. I'm kind of sensing today from all the questions, how many times I've been asked that seems to be a kind of a hot topic of conversation. I don't really understand it too much. You know, I think it's as you get older, you have to be able to accept certain things you can and can't do. And I think there's strength in that vulnerability, I think. And I don't see it being much of an issue.
I know you can't go into all that will be talked about, but Byron talked about what he will say at the team meeting tonight. What are some of the things you'll tell your teammate about the upcoming seasons and the hurdles?
I mean, a lot of things that I just said. I mean, it's the season is such a long season. It's very easy to get boggled down in the day-to-day trivial things, right? You know, I'm sure there'll be a lot of stories being written this year, some of them positive, some of them not. There'll be some games on a Monday that are great, some games on a Friday that are horrible, right? None of it matters. I mean, what matters is staying focused at the end goal and continuing to improve. And if we stay focused on the big picture, not get mired down into day-to-day trivial things, we'll be all right.